In this video, I'll show you three simple ways to fix latency problems in FL Studio. If you've ever tried to record something in FL Studio with high latency, then you know it's guaranteed to cause frustration as everything becomes out of sync. Whether you're trying to record with a microphone or a MIDI device, adequately low latency is imperative to prevent lag and delay. Even if you seem to have nailed it, your accuracy will be influenced by your system's latency. That's the time it takes from when you hit a key on your keyboard until you hear the sound through your speakers. Latency will vary for everyone, and it depends on how fast your computer is, your settings, and how big your project is. Fortunately, most latency problems in FL Studio can be easily fixed by following these simple tips. Number one, make sure that you're using the correct ASIO driver and that the buffer size is not set too high. So let's get into the audio settings and set the latency quite low by adjusting the buffer size. I'm using the Sapphire ASIO driver, and I recommend that you always use the one that comes with your audio interface. Alternatively, you can use this one. Set it as low as you can. Usually anything between 128 and 500 will work fine. Lowering the buffer size is more CPU demanding, though, and can easily overload your system if you don't have a really fast computer. Which brings me to tip number two. If you already have a large project with lots of virtual instruments and effects, lowering the buffering size might overload your CPU, causing glitching and crackling sounds. If I press a key on my MIDI keyboard now, you can hear that there's a significant delay or latency, which makes it extremely difficult to record. To deal with this, you can try temporarily disabling CPU-hungry VSTs like this. In the mixer, you can now use Ctrl+A to select all tracks. You can also turn effects on or off for all selected tracks at once. This will enable you to temporarily reduce the buffer size. Now there's not such a devastating delay anymore. This will make recording much easier. You can re-enable the effects when you're done. Number three, if none of this worked, then you probably have maxed out your CPU. The only thing left to do then is to start freezing tracks. This renders patterns in place as audio, which is much less intensive to process. To freeze a track, just right-click here and select Consolidate Tracks. Press Start. It'll appear as an audio clip and the original pattern will be muted. You can now disable the synth in the channel rack. Now, this was originally going to be this mixer track, but now it's routed directly to the master instead. We can therefore disable all these effects. Alternatively, if you want to be able to adjust the volume, you can route it to the same mixer track or a new one. You can also adjust the volume in the sampler, but I prefer to do my mixing in the actual mixer. You can do this with most of your CPU-intensive synths and mixer tracks with lots of effects on them. That should enable you to lower the buffer size, which again can help reduce the latency enough to record without problems. The frozen tracks can of course be unfrozen if you need to make any changes later. If you tried this and still have problems, or you find it tedious with all these workarounds, then you might have to face the fact that it's time for a faster computer. In that case, I recommend checking out this video about what kind of computer is best suited for music production and why. Also, check out the one on how to optimize CPU performance in FL Studio and how to make CPU-friendly projects. The links are down below. I hope you found this helpful, and if you did, then please like, share, and subscribe. And if you want to support this channel, then consider clicking the thanks button. Thanks for watching.